Spinal muscular atrophy is one of the most common neuromuscular diseases that affect infants and children primarily, but adults as well. It is a rare disease, like many of the diseases we deal with by definition, but within that context, it is really one of the most common. In fact, it's the second most common autosomal recessive disease that we deal with, the most common being cystic fibrosis as such. But spinal muscular atrophy, in fact, is the most common genetic cause of death in infancy. So it's really a very serious condition. So a modest reduction in the SMN protein causes an abnormality in the functioning of the motor neurons. Now the motor neurons send a long process from the spinal cord to the muscle, sending the electrical impulse to the muscle and allowing the muscle to contract in order for a person to carry out a motor activity, either sitting or standing or walking or reaching out for something with your hand. Spinal muscular atrophy is characterized by the clinical presentation and the ability or the lack of ability of the patient to achieve appropriate motor milestones during development. So, for example, going from lying to sitting, or from sitting to standing, and from standing to walking. So we use those milestones to characterize the clinical severity of the condition, and that allows us to define the types or the phenotypes or the clinical features of the disease as such. So type 1 disease, which is the most common of the phenotypes, prevents the child from being able to sit. Type 2 allows the child to sit, but he's unable to stand and walk any distance at all. In type 3, the children are able to sit and to stand and to walk, although at some point in the future they may lose the ability to walk.